our levies. Let's hope and hope we concentrate as Osaya and his beloved wine.
Moving on to the next, I request Brother Asida Maraupe to read out aloud the scripture for the day.
Open with me to Ephesians chapter 1, verse 17 to 23. 17. I keep asking that
man of God.
And among you this evening, time. So it's a great privilege and honor that holy man of God from Manipur has chosen to visit this place and to honor this place and this fellowship with their footfalls. We are really thrilled and we are really excited that you could be among us this day. Surely God shall provide out of his abundance and bless you and your ministries in the days to come. We are also happy that we could host you, but unfortunately the time of your visit, the period is hot summer days in Chennai. It is very difficult even for Chennai to survive this summer. But I think you have found it much more harsher and difficult. But if may God will, maybe we will meet in another day when we have a pleasant climate. I also thank all the brothers and sisters of PHOP who has worked on this tirelessly, especially Brother Jackson, who was working day and night to support the cause of all the pastors coming down. I think he had a very big experience of organizing this event. After he took over as General Secretary, I think this is the biggest event he has organized. So truly you have gained a lot of experience. May God bless him also. I also have to say a few words about Pastor Kesso and his chaplain, Pastor Brother Mikavo. They have been doing the ministry of God among all these people in Chennai. Though AJC is associated with different kind of ministries, we don't have much time to focus on Northeast, but God has risen up Pastor Kesso and Brother Mikavo to work for the cause of the Northeast people. Whether I am here or not, whether I am traveling or not, they are always there to take care of the Northeast people, and they are very much excited about hosting pastors from Northeast. I think this is the third batch of pastors coming down from different tribes. And truly, let God bless them and their ministries in the days to come. I also thank for all the other participants from AJC who helped with the various arrangements. May God bless you all and the days to come. Let God put the fire in the hearts to prepare a righteous generation for God wherever our ministries are located. I truly believe God will do greater things in the day to come. So let us bow our heads in a minute for prayer. Paul writes to the church and tells them, what is the most important thing that men of God needs to seek in his presence? In the verse 19, he goes on to say, and what is the exceeding greatness of his power to us who believe, according to the working of his mighty power. Today we live in a world where success in the church, success in the fellowship is measured by how many people attend the fellowship, how many people come down for the worshipping, how wonderful the services are, how good the word of God that is being preached, how good and better the offerings that we receive. So many things become the standard to measure the success of a ministry. But Paul would travel around the world exhorting and preaching to different people from different cultural background, writes a very important thing that we all need to remember in our lives. He says, for his greatness of his power to us who believe. Today, whenever either it is people from Tamil Nadu or people from Northeast, when they come down to the church, the one thing that I see in the life of people is that people are more worried about the materialistic world. They want to earn more money, they want better lives, they want better homes, they want better cars, they want everything that is better than what they have. They always think that if I had this, if I had that. So what has happened in the days is that the preachers, as well as the chaplains, as well as the people who minister to them, we are tempted to cater to their needs, because when people come and say, they say, first thing they say is, Pastor, please pray that God should bless me. They say, Pastor, please pray I should get a good job. Pastor, please pray my family should be exalted. My children and the future should be blessed. So we are also tempted to minister unto these people according to the richness that they want to seek in this world. We pray for people for the materialistic blessing. We pray for peace in the families. We pray for the surroundings and the jobs that they are working on to be improved. We pray for all those things. But eventually what has happened is that once a person gets a good job, once the person gets a good family, once the person gets peace of mind, once they get lots of money, we cannot see him in the church. He disappears from the church. And then someday he fell sick, then he comes back again. Sometimes he runs into some other problem, he comes back again. So I'm sure that pastors here, you could all relate to that, because we see so many people, we want them to be blessed. We spend our nights sleepless, we research the Bible for their cause, we come and preach and deliver, and finally we see people running away. Sometimes I used to think, it is a great mistake that God blesses some people, because once they are blessed, they disappear.
Established in 40 different countries. So everything was good. But what I could see in that is that the fear of God that was imbibed when I was a child did not help me much when I was in school. Kids used to make fun of us saying that, what, you have to be traditional, why you need to be religious? People used to make fun of me in school. When I went to college, it was the same case. People used to say, come on man, you are in college, you are past your teenage, you can't depend on your parents. Start living the life of this world. It was over. When it came down to real life, everything was different. The same thing that was a matter of people taunting me, people telling that this is not what you need, this is not life is all about, was the same. So today when I look at people, youngsters, they think that, as long as I let me forget it, let me move ahead with my own thoughts. Scriptures by heart, it doesn't matter. You know the songs, so many songs, it doesn't matter. You know to pray and worship and do all those things, it doesn't matter. What really matters is that if one word of God could touch your life and transform, change it, bring you back from the worldly ways to the way of God, if one word of God could do that, blessing in this world. I see so many answers from all these coming down to these showbiz worship services, and they pray, they cry, they meet to God's presence, they listen to sermons and go. But let me ask you, when you go back, when you go back to your homes, when you go back to your jobs, when you go back to do something, is there even a single word of God that stands and floats out of your mind? Is there one word of God that is seated in your heart? When you wake up in the night, when you wake up in the morning, when you go back, it's been preached. Seated with so many great men of business, great men in this world, people who have calmness that the word of God brings to a heart. That is something that no man can find again. Fill it all in all. When we say we are the body of Christ, when we see discrepancies, especially in Northeast, they will say, what is denomination? What denomination do you belong to? We belong to only one denomination. Only kingdom. We are all workers under Jesus Christ. We are all called to partake of the goodness of the Father. We are all led by the Holy Ghost. That is how we are living the life. We are lucky enough, we have pastors from Manipur who has traveled here, who are with us. So it is not just two and three of us that has gathered, but a whole bunch of men of God has gathered here. Which means, surely for sure we know that God is here and that God will bless you. May God bless you all. Thank you. As we have drawn towards the end of today's program, I request Brother Nico, the music director of the HOP, to propose the Lord.
We have a lot of conversations, what we have and what we have. Just no desire. So thank you so much for coming down. We have never expected that you will come down. This must be the you are taking all the burdens though you are in a train, so you are not asleep proper, but the things that you are coming down, so thank you so much. May God bless you all. So I just want to thank your programmers.
Hello, Malika. Sister Malika.
Very nice.
Thank you.
I'm buying.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Right nama. Oh, ayo. Come on, sir. Bye bye. See you. Bye bye.
Bye bye.
See you. Bye bye. Nice. Bye bye.
I can see. Bye bye.